Have you ever had to sit on the bench? Has something happened to you in your life that derailed you and you felt like you could never return to your former glory? I was talking to a friend this morning that I respected greatly that has a wonderful message to share with people. And at one point, he announced that he would stop. I sent him a message this morning and encouraged him to do the same thing again, that I knew that he had a gift, and that gift maybe should be shared with others. His answer came back. He says, "I understand. I'm observing right now." I thought a little bit about that. My friends, we have challenges, we have seasons, and we have things to overcome in our lives. There are so many people that we can look to as our heroes, even if they maybe even had bad behavior or great behavior, but they have overcome and done much better after seasons of disappointment, pain, suffering, and depression. I'd like to remind you, for example, of Michael Jordan, who was cut from his freshman baseball team. He came back also from a brutal loss of a family member. And he also, for example, took a season off to play baseball. Remember Lance Armstrong, one of the most formidable cyclists in the world, now maybe surrounded by a little bit of controversy, but he had testicular cancer that would certainly justifiably derail any man from his definite purpose in life. I'd also like to remind you of Frank Mir, 2004 UFC championship. He was hit while riding a motorcycle. They estimated he flew more than 100 feet in the air and was hurt very badly. The UFC took his title away from him because he could not compete. Frank came back and in 2007 made his return to the octagon. My friends, people can overcome just as well as you. I will remind you of the disappointments of Muhammad Ali that was a conscientious objector. And because of that, he lost his ability to compete for almost 3.5 years. When he did return, he lost what was called the fight of the century when he returned. And then later on, he won two of the greatest fights against two greatest competitors and then won again and again. He retired in 1981, I believe. Think about the Apostle Paul and others that spent significant time incarcerated because of their beliefs. They came back and they were more powerful when they came back. My friends, sometimes we need a little space. We need a little time to think. For example, when we want to get our car detailed, we've got to get out of the car, as one of my favorite mentors says. We've got to go into building and let other people do the work. But when we come back, the wait was worth it. I guarantee you that if you maintain your focus, even in down times, you can win, my friends. Even our Heavenly Father has told us that in times of trouble, He will give us a new heart. So our downtime can give us perspective, it can give us clarity, it can give us the time to really focus on what we need. Or we can choose to become the victim and not accomplish anything because of that. We went through some really hard times globally in this last year and a half with COVID, and I don't want to talk about that too much because I know the range of loss is incomprehensible. But I want to ask you, in whatever situation you're in, have you used this time or can you use this time to be better when it's time to come back and do that one thing that is really your passion? I believe you can, my friends. These are good sayings, and I think if you follow them, I'll see you at the top. Thank you for joining in. This is your friend, Scotty Nichols. We'll talk to you later.